Let's turn our attention now to Tarik Cohen of the Bears. Jim, is Tarik Cohen for real? I mean, I know what he's capable of. He's been a little bit up and down, but it seems like the Bears are starting to commit to him more.
Yeah, it certainly does. And I think you could look at the game script of the past two games and say, hey, I mean, they've been trailing with both the games against the Dolphins and against the Patriots. And both those are scenarios in which you would expect they would use Tarik Cohen more. But then you look back to week four before they had their bye week. That game is where they slaughtered Tampa Bay, and they still use Tarik Cohen in that as well. So I don't think this is just a game script related thing. I think it's pretty legit where Matt Nagy recognizes that Tarik Cohen is a good football player and he wants him to have the ball in his hands. If you look at back to week seven, he had a 51% snap rate, Cohen did, which is his highest of the entire year. If we look at this three game sample where Cohen has been more heavily involved, he has 8, 9, and 12 targets in those three games, which is really good. That's phenomenal for running back. But what's even better is that he's kind of getting used like a wide receiver. He has 5 deep targets in those three games. He has 6 red zone targets. And that is just tremendous usage that you do not usually get out of a running back. So I think when you're looking at Tarik Cohen, you kind of view him as being a wide receiver who gets a couple of carries on top of what he gets as out of the passing game, because he is getting high leverage targets, which again, you don't usually get from a running back. So the price on Tarik Cohen has gone up. He is $7,100 for week 8, but honestly, I think that's a fair price for him based on the usage he has gotten. Again, I think that the way that you look at Tarik Cohen is you say, all right, this guy is basically a wide receiver who gets a couple of carries. And if you would use a wide receiver who gets a couple of carries in that matchup, go ahead and use him. I think that in most scenarios, you're probably going to say yes going forward with Tarik Cohen just because the leverage in the targets that he does get is so high.
You always talk about how much more valuable receptions are for running backs than carries. And when you get 8 receptions, you got to love having Tarik Cohen in your lineup. And you would have definitely loved getting over 18 fantasy points on FanDuel in week 7.